The static data source is a tugboat for large tasks. The static data source is a handy little tool that leads complex tasks to successful completion. Initially, it was created to simplify troubleshooting and development. With time, resourceful users found it useful for two more purposes: discovery and storage. In this video, I will review all four with practical examples, demonstrate the installation, and explain all parameters. Let's go! Installation. To install the plugin, go to the Configuration Plugins menu. Start typing static, click on the plugin card, and then click the Install button. To make the data source available for your dashboards, go to the Configuration Data Sources menu, start typing static, and click on the plugin card to open the configuration window. There are only two parameters here. I keep the suggested name static and switch the toggle to make this a default data source. Save and test. Now I can use the static data source on my dashboards. Initially, the data source was created and supported by Marcus Olsen. Recently, Volkov Labs welcomed the static data source on board, and now we fully maintain it. What is the static data source? In a nutshell, the static data source allows you to mock any data source. For instance, here I add a new panel to my dashboard and choose the static data source. It's not connected to anything. Instead, down here I have the area where I can type in any data points I want. Name is an optional parameter and might be helpful for some experiments. As a rule of thumb, you do not need it if you're unsure about this parameter. The preferred visualization type should only concern you if you work in Explore mode. In the Fields area, I enter the data fields and their types, and in the Values area, I specify the values I want. How to use the static data source for discovery? A couple of months ago, we received a tempting question. You know, the type of questions you want to drop everything and find the answer as soon as possible. The question was whether Apache eCharts could display the wind speed and direction over time on a line chart. I wanted to start working on the proof of concept immediately, skipping the data storage design phase. The static data source is an excellent plugin to do just that. I connected my Apache eCharts panel to the static data source instead of the actual one. I added three fields, time, speed, and direction, and populated values for three data points. Voila! I had a playground to experiment with visualization and focus on answering the question rather than being distracted by the need to connect to the actual data source. And for the records, this is what the graph has turned out to be. Color signifies the speed and arrows point to the wind direction. This is indeed the picture to see instead of thousands of words. Very informative. To sum up the discovery function, you can mimic any data you need and start experimenting with visualization instantly. No need to wait until the production data source is up and running. Storage is one of the resourceful purposes that was a delight to realize. So, what am I talking about? Let's say you have a small piece of constant data that needs to be displayed on the Grafana dashboard. In my experience, it was an image that analysts were required to add to the dashboard to make the dashboard stand out from all others. Creating a table just for that one image sounded like a big hustle, especially since the analysts did not have access to the database. The solution was to add the static data source with just one field populated with the image converted into Base64 format. That's it! Grafana's flexible architecture and communities will continue to amaze me. To summarize the storage function, the static data source can capture some data elements right on your Grafana dashboard. What can the static data source do for troubleshooting and development? A great example I have for this is as follows. One of our visualization plugins generated an odd error. The main suspect was the possible problem with how the plugin works with one of the particular data type, date. The quickest solution was to connect our visualization panel to the static data source, specify the potentially erroneous data type, and work from there. To summarize the troubleshooting and development functionality, the static data source is an excellent aid when you need to dissect the complex processes into parts. The static data source lets you to focus on the plugin. This is all I planned for this video. Let me know if you need another episode about this plugin where I talk in detail about the Explore mode and preferred visualization types. Remember, we opened the sponsorship on our GitHub. Joining the Sponsors Club is a quick and easy way to say thank you for our work. Thanks for watching and see you next time.